Welcome to Tali Tadka, Vikas.
Thank you so much.
In the 11 years that you've been in the industry, please take us through as to what made you become an actor.
Probably,
Welcome to Tali Tadka.
Thank you very much.
Vikas, first of all, congratulations on your new project with Geet.
Thank you.
And we want to know how you're looking forward to this new role that you have.
I'm fairly looking forward to it because it's a very different character. I've not done so far. People have seen me negative, but I've done negative as in like people love my negative shade because somewhere or the other I was fighting for my mother or my brother's right. They're not giving it.
Right.
So, but this thing is very unique. I can't reveal it because it's not published as yet.
Right.
As a story wise, but the character is very, 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 very strong.
Okay.
As far as the promos are running on the television, I think everybody can guess what kind of character he's going to be.
Yeah, so what we hear that he's going to be a stalker is, again, I'm telling what I hear. You don't have to confirm it or whatever. But as far as what we know, it's going to be a friend of Geet who has re-emerged into her life.
Mm-hmm.
And he is probably obsessive about her or has suddenly turned obsessive and realized that he needs to get back to her. Considering that we are assuming that's the role, how difficult do you think a stalker is to play?
Stalker as in, yeah, of course, never been a stalker in real life. But every role is difficult, but the thing is you need to know, you need to get into the character first, and then maybe, I don't research or something like that. Something like that, because you know what stalker is. So I don't know how bold they can go on TV in India or as such, but yeah, with my language and my style, I play a lot of I don't like right now also, like sometimes I don't even look at the camera.
Okay.
I don't even look at the person and I just say, you know, like my line will say everything and I just look at her probably or him, and the kind of reaction they get out of sudden, like what happened to him, you know, like in rehearsal he was doing something else and now because I'm very spontaneous, I know, while talking also when I'm saying my dialogue, you know, I keep on improvising.
Okay.
I with each and every take there's different take.
Right.
I can't repeat myself right now.
Okay.
It's a talent or a bad thing. Well,
personally, improvisation is a good thing because it keeps you probably interested in the scene that you're doing. That would be my take.
Yeah.
Obviously, from a director's perspective, it could be a different ball game, or from a writer's perspective, it could be something else
altogether.
Yeah.
Sometimes I need to stick to lines. Sometime, but most of the time, when ever I've done any project. I got full liberty with my lines and my dialogues and everything. Because I don't change the content of the scene.
Right.
Because your lingo can be different and mine can be different. So, which is easier to me, it can be shown on my face very fantastically. Few words are tongue twisters.
Mm-hmm.
So you probably think another word. So I'm not saying I'm going to change the entire thing about it, but the improvisation keeps on coming. Like, if I'm looking at you, then probably next take, I won't.
Right.
So, they have variations. And I've never faced such problem where, like I said, you know, like you have,
don't
to,
do
have
this.
To, have to. And I've always got backup from everybody that, you know, do it. Read the scene and do it, you know. Let's see.
I guess that works for you and then works for them too. Because,
yeah, because
you bringing in something new, your own essence perhaps to the script.
Yeah, because as an actor, it's my duty to read the scene and to conceive myself doing it. Yes, I need to follow director's order, but it's a teamwork.
Correct.
Like, he can't teach me how to act. Like, if I know the scene, I'm not changing the essence and everything. And there's a little bit of modulation. Okay, sometimes 70% of mine is in the scene and 30% is, you know, okay, probably you were going a little right here, why can't we go a little straight and look better?
Correct.
So it works like that.
Right. How is it working with Drashti Dami? Have you worked with her before?
No. In fact, I haven't met her before.
So how was the experience?
No, I've not met her.
You haven't met her yet?
I haven't met her.
Oh, so have you heard anything about her that that would probably put you at ease or at discomfort at any in anything
no,
like that?
No, I'm very, 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 very professional. I don't know. I just go work and come back home.
So far, what have you done in terms of your advent into Geet? Is it just the promo that you've done at all? Because a promo that I saw did not reveal you. It was just the voice.
Yeah.
So is it just the voice you've done, or have you done more than that already? You don't have to say what you've done, just if you've done more.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So where you come from, probably your background story or something like that.
I don't know.
Okay, right. Okay.
I don't know.
Now,
I'm random.
Looking at the face behind the voice in Geet,
yeah.
I'm sure the fans are going to be looking forward to number one, considering that you've done different roles before, mostly gray shades, if
yeah.
I don't say it as total negative.
Yeah.
Would this be similar to those roles in terms of negative or grey shades, or will it be an out and out negative role?
It'll be something different. Something different, and I'll try to take it to a different level. I promise people have seen me earlier in negative roles, but probably playing a grey character, you have so much to do, so much to play with.
Right.
And I've enjoyed doing it, seriously. And there's nothing like hero or like, you look at so many people, you know, they want to do negative. Look at Aamir Khan, he's doing 2, 3, he's playing negative.
Yeah.
Hrithik played.
Right.
Bachchan Saab played.
Right.
So, it's an actor.
Correct.
You're an actor.
Right. So what?
So it's a. Sometimes you say also like, you know, he's a negative hero.
Right.
Yeah, they say it.
Yeah.
There is a term.
Yeah.
But like they say,
yeah.
He's a negative hero, you know. The moment he's going to come, something's going to happen.
Right.
So, probably, I don't know. I enjoy it.
Okay. Now, in Geet, considering that people do know you in terms of what you've done, so. Do you think there could be a brush that they would use to say, oh, now that he has entered as the stalker or whatever terminology the fans or the viewers call it, do you think that's going to color what they would expect from the character? Would they be pleasantly surprised, or they'll be shocked to probably see that you're not doing exactly what they're expected, or are they going to get what they're expecting?
No, I think so. They're gonna see me what I've done earlier.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely not. And let me just, you know, it's early thing. Like, sometime, you know, I'm gonna go and few scenes. I'm not gonna be stalker, like, you know, go on tour and like, I can be polite sometimes.
Right.
I can be very nice and stuff.
Right, right.
So, maybe I'll change something. Maybe I'll think about something. Maybe, I don't know. Let's see.
Right, right, right. I have seen you in Kahin Toh Hoga,
yeah.
Where you were the smooth talker. Yeah? If I remember correctly. I have not seen too much of the serial, but whatever I've seen, your interaction with Anjumendru, and with Sujal, right? Sujal was the character.
Sujal and
Kashish. So, yeah.
Yeah.
So whatever I've seen is that you obviously were not revealing what you were there. Would I see something like that in Geet as well?
I was not revealing in Kahin To Hoga that what I was.
You were not?
No. Probably from day one I was open.
No, only the viewers knew it. The people did not know it. The people in the serial, Kashish did not know what you were all about. The mother did not suspect that you were trying to avenge for her. The father did not know.
So it's
the viewers who know. That's good.
Yeah, but the thing is, that's in the hand of the writer, screenplay writer. So I can't say that. I can't because that the only aspect of the a movie or of the show that I won't interfere.
Correct.
I can suggest definitely, but I can't interfere.
Correct.
So I wouldn't know. Even I don't know.
So what made you take up this role?
I don't know. it's a youth-oriented channel, so they called me up, so I felt really nice. So, yeah.
I'm sure you are.
I won't tell you my age. I won't mind, actually. 37.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah.
That's young.
Really?
Yeah. Of course it's young. Otherwise, I would be somewhere there too, right? If I called you older. And coming to why you took this role is one thing. But what would you expect out of this role to do for you, personally as well as professionally, if anything?
See, people are going to be very happy that I'm back. Of course, there's going to be a shocking value to it, definitely. And it's already been on television that I'm entering.
Right.
So people kind of, they think he might, but the thing is, they don't know how I am. So let's see. Probably be different.
Right. So looking forward to you. I'll take your pictures too, guys. Looking forward to your stint, or I hope it's a long term, as long as Geet lasts, or whatever your stint is. Looking forward to seeing you in there, and good luck with that. And if you could just tell your fans as to what they can look forward to.
I promise that I'll give my 100% in each and every line, word, scene, to make you guys satisfied. As my fan, you've been watching for the last 11 years and I've been loved by you guys, and surely we can't be without you guys. So I promise I'll always try to serve you in a different brand every time.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.